I got the horse right here, the name is Paul Revere, and here's a guy that says if the weather's clear, can do, can do. This guy says the horse can do. If he says the horse can do, can do, can do.
I picked him Valentine, 'cause on the morning line, the guy has got him figured at 5 to 9.
But his epitaph, he wins it by a half, according to this here and that telegraph.
For Paul Revere, I'll bite, I hear his foot's all right. Of course, it all depends if it rained last night.
I know it's Valentine, 'cause on the morning line, the guy has got him figured at 5 to 9.
But just a minute, boys, I got some feedback. Noise, it says the great grandfather was equipoised.
I tell you, Paul Revere, now this is no bum steer. It's from a handicapper that's real sincere.
I know it's Valentine, the morning works look fine. You know the jockey's brother's a friend of mine.
So make an epitaph, he wins it by a half, according to this here and that telegraph. Epitaph,
Valentine,
Paul Revere, I got the horse.
That means it happened exactly 200 years ago. 200 years ago, the Highlands of Scotland were plagued with witches, wicked sorcerers who were taking the Scottish people away from the teachings of God and putting the devil into their souls. They were indeed horrible, destructive women. I don't suppose you have such women in your country.
Witches?
Oh, we have them. We pronounce it differently.
No, it did not matter that they were not real sorcerers, because you and I know there's no such thing. But their influence was very real indeed. Now, we had at that time in Brigadoon an old minister of the kirk named Mr. Forsyth. And a good man he was.
The kindest man in Scotland.
I believe he was. Ah, no man loved his parish as did Mr. Forsyth. But he was getting old, and it grieved him that one day soon he'd have to leave those he loved so well. But most of all, he worried about the witches. Now, mind you, they hadn't visited us yet in Brigadoon, but he knew that there was a band of them coming our way. So he began to wonder whether there wasn't something he could do to protect the folk of his parish, not only against them, but against all the evils that might come to Brigadoon from the outside world after he died. Then one day he came to me and told me that he had decided to ask God for a miracle. And on an early Wednesday morn, recht after midnight, he went out to a hill beyond Brigadoon and made his prayer to God. And there in the hush of a sleeping world, he asked God that night to make Brigadoon and all the people in it vanish into the Highland mist. Vanish. But not for always. They would return just as they were for one day every 100 years. The people would lead their customary lives, but every day when they awoke, it would be 100 years later. And when we awoke next day, it was 100 years later. You see, in this way, Mr. Forsythe figured that there'd be no change in the lives of the people. They just wouldn't have been any century long enough to be touched by it.
You mean that you go to bed at night and when you wake up the next day, it's 100 years later?
Aye.
Then every day is 100 years later?
Aye.
What happened to the minister?
We near saw him again. You see, he realized to ask for such a miracle, some sacrifice would have to be made, and he wanted to be the one to make it. Well, what was the greatest sacrifice that he could offer? It was to be separated from those he loved before his time, and that was why he went up to a hill beyond Brigadoon, where his miracle granted, he'd never see Brigadoon again.
All this happened 200 years ago.
Aye, lad. Which, of course, to us, you see, is only 2 days ago.
Let me ask you something. Suppose somebody around here got fed up and wanted to leave. Then what?
Well, he cannot leave.
You mean I've got to stay here now?
No, lad. But according to Mr. Forsythe's contract with God, if anyone belonging to Brigadoon leaves, the enchantment will be broken for all.
Mm-hmm.
And that night, when all the people go to sleep, Brigadoon will disappear forever.
Look, I'm not saying I believe all this, but just for argument's sake, suppose a stranger like me, came to Brigadoon and wanted to stay. Could he?
Aye, he could. Mr. Forsythe provided for that.
He didn't miss a trick, did he?
No, lad, he did not. Now, a stranger can stay if he loves someone here, and not Brigadoon itself, mind you, but someone in Brigadoon enough to be willing to give up everything to stay near that person. Which is only right, because after all, lad, if you love someone deeply enough, anything is possible.
Aye. Anything is possible.
Oh, Fiona, shouldn't you be thinking of changing for the wedding?
I had. Tommy, will I see you later?
I'll be there. I'd like to stick around and see if this place evaporates like you say.
I must hurry now. Goodbye, Mr. Lundy. And thank you.
You're going to have to ask him.
But is there any situation which you would accept even a dollar of wall funding for this president in order to reopen the government?
A dollar?